Why medication? A talk given by Venerable Dr. K. Sri Dhammananda Nayaka Thera at the Buddhist Vihara, Kuala Lumpur.
Meditation actually is not an accurate word to describe the term bhavana used by the Buddha. The Buddha introduced this noble method of mental training mainly for mental development leading to mental purification. The general meaning of meditation is to think on or concentrate seriously. However, if we use the term meditation for mental culture or mental training as taught by the Buddha, we use it in a narrow sense for the word bhavana. I hope now you can see the difference between meditation in a general sense and the specific Buddhist practice of bhavana. Bhavana is used to develop and purify the mind. The Buddha developed this method to guide us because mind is the most difficult thing for us to train. Although we can train people and animals to do all kind of clever things, it is very difficult for us to train our own mind. Meditation, therefore, is the most complicated task in this world. Many people have misused and misled others in the name of meditation for their personal material gain. To the serious student, however, meditation is the only way to find peace and realize the ultimate of life. The Buddha discovered this method and he made the practice of it central to his teaching. In fact, it was through the meditation practice he had developed that he attained his own enlightenment. He made it very clear that this is the only method for us to gain final liberation from an unsatisfactory existence in this life. Those who cannot understand that mental purification is important for final emancipation try to introduce other methods to gain their so-called salvation or freedom from physical and mental suffering. If one asks, what made Buddhism unique amongst all the other religions? The answer is meditation. In Buddhist practice, a system of meditation is directed entirely and exclusively at mental purification, unlike in other faiths where such practices concentrate and rely on external supernatural powers. No one can deny that meditation can help modern materialistic man develop his latent powers of insight. But it must be recognized that it has only recently become fashionable nowadays for some people to boast that they have developed all kinds of skills in meditation. They have promised their followers many powers in return for large sums of money. Those people claim that they have gained supernormal powers through their meditation skills. It is true that one can develop extraordinary skills through meditation, but a skill in meditation alone is not enough. Many of these so-called meditation masters have not shown any mental culture or spiritual development. In Buddhism, the development of these forces of the mind must be accompanied by mental purification, which have little to do with mere faith. True meditation must be practiced with the aspirations of liberating oneself from the fetters of selfish and evil thoughts that bind all beings to the wheel of existence, the cause of suffering. Any power gained over the mundane world is without purpose, because the only reality is realizing the futility of the concept of reality in component things. Today, no one can live peacefully without fear, suspicion, and tension. Each and every being that exists creates some sort of trouble to cause suffering to others. They suffer at the hand of others because of their ignorance. Why do people create troubles to violate peace and happiness of innocent people? It is due to their selfishness. Naturally, selfishness arises in the untrained mind. Whatever method we adopt to train that untrained mind, whether it is scientific or technological, is inadequate. There is no proper development or understanding in the mind which is a slave to materialistic consideration. Man is becoming more and more violent, is jealous, and harbor anger. This results in enormous destruction. Over the centuries, certain methods have been discovered by wise people for men to understand the need to lead a respectable life. The culture of any community is based on these basic moral principles set out by the wise men. But unfortunately, men abuse all these noble methods which are found in their culture, religion, and politics. Modern man seems to apply his selfishness and jealousy to anything that he handles. One man cannot trust another, although they live together. Although the world is thickly populated, somehow men find that there is a feeling of insecurity and loneliness, because one man has no confidence in another man. It is very difficult to understand what is in a man's mind, because while he can pretend that he is cultured, civilized, educated, or religious, nobody can recognize him for the crook that he really is. This is the nature of man's mind. He can bluff, swindle, cheat, mislead others for his own benefit. When you study the nature of man's crookedness, you can understand that animals are better than humans, because animals are not cunning and never mislead others. The two-legged animals who live in concrete jungle are unreliable and selfish, and endanger their society and introduce all sorts of immoral practices to mislead others for their own benefit. People try to show that they are cultured or civilized, but when you compare the differences, I think animals are more admirable than human beings. Unscrupulous men can develop their mental power through meditation and use these powers for diabolical purposes. But on Buddhist meditation, one must get true insight, learn the real nature of existence, discard selfish desire. This kind of meditation is the only solution to train man's mind, to rid him of his crookedness. Certain religious principles and guidelines are the prerequisite to the proper development of the mind. Otherwise, unprincipled men will continue to violate and disturb the whole world. According to modern scientific knowledge, we know that if there is any being which can destroy the world that human beings inhabit, it is man. In the past, people had some mythological belief that one day either a god or devil would destroy this world. Now you can see for yourself who is actually going to destroy this world. The fate of nearly 5,000 million humans is in one man's hand. If that man presses a button, within half an hour, he can destroy the whole world and turn every living thing into ashes. Modern man has developed his mind and used this mind to create many things which have given us comfort. Yet, at the same time, this highly developed mind has been abused. Animals lead a natural life by instinctively following their animal needs. On the other hand, humans violate his nature, and as a result, he faces enormous problems because of his unnatural behavior. Animals have not discovered the grandeur of science like atomic energy, chemistry, biology, and mathematics. But they are living without facing many problems that man has to face today. Animals have only few problems, such as satisfying their need for food, sex, and shelter. Our needs are so great. We are constantly increasing our desires, anxieties, and we have become crazy because of our anxieties, and we have no contentment or satisfaction. Whenever we gain something, we want something else. That is the reason why we are not happy. We also constantly abuse our five senses. The senses are necessary to find our food, our living, and for our protection. Animals use their senses only for that purpose. But today, we abuse our senses by neglecting the proper way to provide ourselves with food and clothes. For our indulgence, there is too much demand for amusement, entertainment, and worldly pleasure. We have become crazy. How can we find peace, happiness, and calmness when we crave so much? Observe the behavior of animals and birds. When they get up early in the morning, how happy they are. They get up early in the morning to find their food, and they dance and sing. They do not get up early to go to their office. They do not carry any suitcase or sleeping tablets, heart tablets, vitamin tablets, or gastric tablets, or even family planning tablets. On the other hand, when you wake up early in the morning and look at your face, what does it look like? There is no serenity or cheerfulness. We are always busy running here and there to indulge our senses. We have no time to go to bed at the proper time, and we cannot get up early because we are so tired. We have no time to take a rest or to relax. When we are sick, we swallow some tablets or get an injection and run to work to earn a living, to buy the thousands and one material objects which we think are essential to healthy living. But how far can we run like this? We say we are preparing to enjoy our life by earning more. But while preparing to enjoy our life, on the way, suddenly, we may die. Today, so many people suffer from gastric ulcers, heart problems, high blood pressure, nervous breakdown, and many other mental problems because of the frustration, anxiety, jealousy, and unhealthy competition that they have developed in their mind. They never think such attitude can create enormous damage to their physical bodies, brain cells, organs and glands, blood circulation and heart. Many wealthy people end their lives in the same pitiful plight as ant fallen in a cup of honey. Their physical condition have been reduced to such a pathetic level that people succumb to untimely death as a result of all kinds of sicknesses. That is why meditation is important to calm the mind, to give a chance for it to relax. When our minds are disturbed by fear, anger and excitement, we are not only poisoned, but we also experience many physical disorders. For example, when our digestive system does not work properly, we will experience high blood pressure, blood clot, a skin disease, and the whole body will be affected. When the mind is disturbed, the four basic elements of the body also get agitated. When the solid element is disturbed, any kinds of growth or cancerous tumor can form. When the fluid element is disturbed, different kinds of dropsy result due to the accumulations of fluid. When the heat element is agitated, fever and certain skin disease appear. When the wind element is agitated, chronic bronchitis and some other problems appear. In fact, the human body is just like the battleground on which guns and bombs and other destructive equipment are set in preparing for a war. The four elements are considered to be powerful army generals ready to wage a war against each other, according to their qualities of solidity or cohesion, heat or cold, and pressure, support or prop. Their daily military actions on the battleground result in the destruction of the human body. In other words, such destructive forces affect the human person in the form of all kinds of disease. Understanding people maintain balanced mind above all other things. When our mind is at peace, hormone secretion will be normal and we will be able to lead a healthy life. On the other hand, the body is like a flower. The mind is like its fragrance. When we meditate on loving kindness, the fragrance of the flower of the mind spreads not only around that area, but all over the world. The Buddha says, contentment is the highest wealth. If we can maintain this attitude, we can avoid so many sicknesses, disappointments, and problems. Contentment does not mean that we should not work hard to earn something for our living. Today, man has forgotten the value of contentment. That is why there is unhealthy competition among men. Mahatma Gandhi once said, "Here in this world, we can find everything for our need, but not for our greed." Again he said, "Fewer the need, greater the happiness." Young people live for the future by creating dreams about their lives. At the same time, old people live in the past by thinking about the pleasures experienced during their youth. But we must learn how to live according to present circumstances. We have forgotten and neglected the ancient wisdom and organized our way of life in such a way, thinking that we will be able to enjoy ourselves at a later date, but we do not know we are digging our own graves. The modern world creates excitement, but not happiness. This excitement creates a lot of disturbances in our mind and our nervous system. Meditation is the only method to calm the mind and nervous system in order to lead a healthy life, not only for spiritual development. The Buddha has said, "Health is the highest gain." If we neglect our health, no matter what we gain, we will have to lead a very miserable life. The trouble with us today is that we neglect our health and our period of relaxation in order to enjoy the worldly life. But the way modern society has organized things to make people enjoy life can create a lot of damage to the mind and body. Many immoral practices have become very common in the modern way of life. People go after these things in the name of pleasure, but later they regret it because they suffer ill health spiritually and physically. Some people see it is very difficult for them to practice meditation because there are a lot of disturbances. In fact, there is no place in this world where there are no disturbances. No one can stop disturbances. But if we are wise, if we can understand things properly, we will know how to guard our mind in spite of various disturbances. Do you know what the Buddha has said for those who want to calm the mind in spite of various disturbances? He says, when you happen to see something, do not close your eyes, because if you close your eyes, it will become a nuisance and it will disturb you more. You should look at it. Look at it in its proper perspective and not superficially. It is very hot. You know that it is not possible to stop the heat of the sun, but you can use an umbrella or some shade to avoid the heat. In the same manner, you must have the determination to stop the sound vibration from affecting your mind. Don't allow your mind to absorb it. You have to train your mind in this way to maintain peace. This is the technique we have to learn from Buddhism, because there is no other academic discipline in this world which can guide us how to train the mind. Albert Einstein has said, atomic energy has shaken the whole world, but even atomic energy cannot train a man's mind. This is the nature of the mind. So, the object that we create in our mind. Meditation is the only means by which we can guard our mind. In order to meditate, we had to provide an object for the mind to hold on to. Therefore, when we begin to train the mind, we had to provide it with something to hold its attention. This is like giving something to a small child to stop his crying. However, the object of meditation must be neutral. At the same time, if the object is ugly, horrible looking, then the mind creates a loathing toward it. In both cases, the attachment or loathing will create emotions and distract the mind. So, if it is to calm the mind, the object that we choose must prevent both pleasant and unpleasant feelings. At the same time, we should not force anybody to meditate if the person is not interested, because no one can train the mind by force. It is most important for the person to himself want to enjoy the benefit of meditation. There is a criticism regarding this meditation. People say, when we try to control our anger, jealousy and temptation, that attitude itself disturbs the mind. Yes, this is true psychologically. In fact, it also explains the danger of such attitude. For meditation to be possible, the mind must be completely neutralized. At the beginning, one will find it extremely difficult. Of course, remember, we had said earlier that the most difficult task a man can perform anywhere is to tame his mind. We cannot control the mind by force, but only through understanding. Buddhism never forces anybody to meditate, but explains the nature of life in its proper perspective, the nature of the world and worldly conditions, the nature of suffering, the fleeting nature of pleasure. By understanding the real nature of componenting, we can realize that all sensations are mind-created. Then we will realize that to gain happiness, we must calm and control the mind. Only then will we willingly consent to practice meditation. If you force those who cannot understand its value to meditate, it is exactly like forcing an untrained wild monkey to sit quietly without shaking its legs. You know that a monkey cannot do this because it is not used to this discipline. Practicing meditation without full confidence does not produce good results because the mind cannot appreciate it. Therefore, the mind experiences mental unrest because we are going to do something which the mind had not been prepared for earlier. Meditation is something we have to do willingly. However, if people practice meditation by realizing its value, it can contribute a great deal towards mental training and peace. Those who are hot-tempered, temperament and moody and crazy about many things will benefit. Meditation strengthens the mind and helps it to understand things properly. Medical science and psychology also cannot help to control or wipe out mental disturbances such as frustrations and worries in people's minds, because these things are not organic disorders but created by the mind due to a person's own mental attitude. There is no remedy for that besides meditation. People have been practicing meditation for thousands of years to maintain themselves, to cultivate their mind, and to overcome their problems and worries without creating further mental disturbances. Mind is the most dynamic force in this world. A single thought which appears in this invisible mind can save or destroy the world. This mind is a gold mine, but people dump rubbish into it and pollute it. Mental pollution can create enormous disturbances, and therefore mind must be properly guided by discipline and reason. Otherwise, there can be a burst of action which man himself is thereafter powerless to control. The Buddha has said, no enemy can harm one so much as one's thought of craving, thought of hatred, thought of jealousy. When we master our mind, we can use it properly. Otherwise, life can become a nuisance to ourselves and others as well. These internal enemies harm us more than the external enemies. We suffer more due to worry, enmity, and irritability generated by them. Therefore, we had to fight to overcome them by using some sort of weapons such as concentration and wisdom. Wisdom is the bullet and ammunition. Concentration or the calmness of the mind is the firing of it. Religious precept or seal help to bring about our inner development. This method is more significant and effective for winning ourselves rather than winning our way into outer space. Man has turned the whole world into a time bomb because he has not tamed his mind. The life of every living being is in danger. Meditation is necessary to diffuse the time bomb in man's mind. Man cannot change the chaotic situation in this world unless he determines to bring peace and happiness for others to live peacefully. To do that, we have to train our mind. Whatever we do without training our mind can become a failure, which can create a lot of problems and miseries. People have chosen the wrong path to realize the purpose of life. The purpose of life, to many understanding people, is to reduce selfishness and to do some service to others. People can pray and worship many times a day and beg heaven to give them happiness and prosperity. Worshipping and praying to God and spirit are carried out in a competitive manner. Temples, mosques, and churches are fully crowded. Man's mind is crowded with evil thoughts, selfishness, grudges, enmity, jealousy. It should be replaced with purity or wisdom if we are to save this world. Religion is important not only to make us pray and worship and perform rites and rituals, but to introduce certain principles or good qualities in order to behave as cultured human beings with humane qualities. Otherwise, there is no purpose in having a religion. Some religions do not allow man to think freely, but force people to accept certain dogmas in the name of religion. They do not allow people to use their human intelligence, and they abuse human dignity. They introduce many beliefs which simply increase our anxiety and craving, but do nothing to calm the mind. They aim not at imparting wisdom, but spreading superstitious ideas. The purpose of religion is to train the mind and not to blindfold a human being. When we develop our mind to the maximum by cultivating virtues and good qualities, by maintaining our human dignity, and by observing morality and discipline, we can attain perfection. We pay homage to those who have achieved that end. People work day and night to become rich, to enjoy life, but after struggling for a long period to gain what they need, in the end, they only experience disappointment, fear, and insecurity. It is only when they are in trouble that they realize that money cannot release them from their problem. Only then do they remember the value of contentment and go in search of those who have renounced all their pleasures, property, and lead a humble and simple life. They are then willing to pay their respect to such penniless and religious people and appeal for blessing, for protection. They say they are in trouble and they need blessing from such holy people. Here you can compare those who can really enjoy their life and those who accumulate wealth to enjoy the worldly life. The really happy ones are those who have developed detachment and maintained peace and contentment in their life. Meditation need not be given any religious label. Anyone who has a mind can practice meditation. If the mind is ready, it can be trained and made use of for good purpose. People misuse their mental energy for unnecessary things. Mental energy can be harnessed and utilized to do some service to others and to serve oneself. This energy is the strongest force in this universe. All the other energies are blind forces. But mental energy is an intelligent force. If this energy is properly guided, it can be used to divert all the other existing energies for many good purposes. Otherwise, people can misuse this energy for destructive purposes. For example, let us take atomic energy, which was discovered by human mind. The mind can utilize this energy for constructive or destructive purposes. Today, people seem anxious to use this energy only to destroy the whole world. Unless we control and harness our mental energy, great destruction can result. The mind can utilize this energy for constructive or destructive purposes. Today, people seem anxious to use this energy only to destroy the whole world. Unless we control and harness our mental energy, great destruction can result. Today, all over the world, even non-Buddhists practice meditation. Although their main purpose is not for spiritual development, they have seen good results where their physical problems such as tension, blood pressure, gastric troubles, and various other sicknesses have been reduced. Meditation really helps one to overcome ill health and to maintain good health and purity in the mind. Do you know that when we harbor evil thoughts in our mind for a long period, these pollutions cause much damage to our physical body, especially the brain cells, the nervous system, blood circulation. As a result, after a long time, we experience many bad effects. It is clear that medical science also agrees that the mind can be the source of sicknesses. On the other hand, the same mind can be used to cure sicknesses. So the mind must be used carefully. Otherwise, it becomes a nuisance to us. scientific education, without proper mental training or religious discipline, can create disaster in this world. Actually, it is happening all over the world. Clever people who have no wisdom and compassion abuse their intelligence by adopting modern techniques slavishly. Primitive people never needed to use dangerous techniques to destroy anything. Our ancestors had minor problems compared to the enormous problems we face today. All over the world, people are fighting each other. Some of them justify it as a holy war. But war is war, no matter whether it is holy or unholy. Buddhism teaches us that killing for any reason is unpardonable. It is worse when people fight and kill in the name of religion. What is the difference between war and a dog fight? The only difference is that dogs never organize themselves earlier for their fight. Human beings organize and fight. But the paradox is that man's untamed mind makes him fight. Then he uses all his cleverness and knowledge to organize massive tactical maneuver to kill, rape, and plunder. Here, we see that cleverness and wisdom are different things. A wise man is one who is in complete control of his mind. Meditation can contribute a lot to tame the wicked mind. By knowing that God and devil both are in our mind, we watch our every thought very carefully and act mindfully. We must try to find out the nature of the thought which appear in the mind. Examining the thoughts that appear is in itself an act of meditation. Buddhism teaches how to maintain mindfulness. When we become aware that certain ideas are not dangerous and harmful to us as well as to others, we must try to develop and nurture such thoughts. They are useful and can contribute to the welfare of others and for ourselves. Again, when we talk, we must be fully aware of what we talk before words are allowed to come out from the mouth. We have to balance and judge carefully whether these words are useful, harmful, dangerous, or whether they hurt others' feelings. We must know how to use the proper words and talk mindfully. Again, when we are going to do something, such as walking, sitting, sleeping, eating, there must be some mindfulness. When we do something without mindfulness, we can easily make mistakes and disturb others, and we also harm ourselves in the process. We must be constantly on guard to prevent the mind from wandering here and there. We must fix our mind towards our thoughts, words, and actions. Then we can do our work efficiently, and we can avoid many problems and disturbances. Sometimes, due to our negligence, we make mistakes and face many difficulties, and later we regret our negligence. By calming and strengthening our mind, certain purifications take place, and this mental purification can influence the mind to perform certain phenomena. People regard them as supernatural powers. Anyway, whatever word we use to describe these powers, they are worldly and not spiritual. We should not be crazy about so-called supernatural powers. Some phenomena appear in the mind when it is developed. People always seek to gain supernatural powers through meditation. The reason is that when the natural latent mental energies are developed through meditation, so-called supernatural powers appear. When people without the necessary spiritual maturity develop one aspect of their mind only through meditation, they experience extreme excitement. This can cause fear and result in mental imbalance. The spiritually mature person who meditates and gains powers over the material world remains unexcited by them because he knows that he needs to go a long way before he can attain the final goal. There is an amusing story about a man who boasted to the Buddha that as a result of great effort he had mastered the art of walking on the water. The Buddha remarked that it was not necessary to waste all that effort if one's intention was merely to cross the river, for a boatman could easily have ferried him across. One should develop the mind to cross the wheel of existence to attain final salvation. Therefore, we must know how to balance our mind and not to be crazy for such powers. Since the aim of Buddhist meditation is to calm or purify the mind, if we practice this meditation with full understanding, there won't be any bad effect. It is true that some young fanatics have gone mad trying to develop their powers too soon. But if we have the right attitude to understand, we need not worry about it. The Buddhist way to perform meditation starts with sila, samadhi and panya. That means morality, concentration and wisdom. First, we have to develop our moral background by observing certain moral principles and virtues to guard ourselves. That is the foundation for us to build up our religious way of life. After that, we have to concentrate more on mental development to maintain purity, calmness, peace in the mind. That is samadhi. When the mind is calmed, we gain panya or wisdom, realization. Through meditation, we gain calmness of the mind or understanding or wisdom. That is the main purpose in our life. That is the purpose of our religious life. The confidence and understanding that we gain through this meditation are very important for our lives, so that we can avoid undue worries and frustration that we create because of our ignorance. We imagine that our problems are due to the influence of devils or ghosts or charms and black magic. To prevent such problems and not to suspect or blame others, we should try to understand the true nature of life. We will get true understanding as well as wonderful knowledge through meditation. Only then can we experience satisfaction without creating further problems. So, in various ways, in our day-to-day life, and not only for spiritual development, this meditation makes it very easy for us to maintain patience and tolerance. Because of meditation, it will not be easy for others to provoke or disturb us. Then we can understand things properly and see them in their correct perspective. When you observe some people carefully and notice how they behave, how they talk, and when they are confronted by others, you can understand that their attitude is different from ordinary people, and how they maintain gentleness and cheerfulness. Their appearance indicates the development of their mind. On the other hand, there are those who try to show their cleverness or superiority and always show a challenging and hostile attitude. This indicates immaturity and shallowness of their mind. Each individual has his own intrinsic character or behavior, and we can categorize them as animal nature, devilish nature, human nature, and divine nature. Meditation is a method we can use to tame the animal nature and devilish nature within us. Some people do not behave as cultured people. They are rough and rude. They do not know how to tolerate anything. That clearly shows that they have not tamed their animal or devilish nature, although they are human beings. By controlling these weaknesses, he should assess what are the mental weaknesses and hindrances of a person. When he knows all these characteristics, he introduces an object of meditation for the mind to hold on to. That object must be a neutral one for the meditator. The earlier method for a beginner is to concentrate on breathing in and breathing out. Although we breathe every moment of our life, we never concentrate on it and we are even unaware of it. Concentrating on breathing is a very easy method for us to train the mind. When we train the mind for some time, we experience some changes on our way of thinking and way of life. We can reduce our so many wrong attitudes and moods. As a result, many changes take place in our life. After developing this for some time, the meditation master may introduce another object for further development. But some people practice the same method from the very beginning to the end because they are satisfied with it and experience improvement. Some people do not gain any improvement in their meditation, although they practice it for some time. They even experience some uneasiness when they meditate on certain objects. The reason is they have chosen the wrong object for their meditation. And the wrong object also can create some physical or mental problem, although this is not in itself dangerous. But this meditation can disturb emotionally unstable people who find it difficult to balance their mind. Mental instability that is aroused by emotion can create some problems. Besides this, undue anxiety that people create in their mind also can create some disappointment and later cause mental imbalance. Beginners are frustrated because they like to experience good results immediately. If you understand the nature of the mind, however, you know it is not easy to gain immediate results. Stubbornness, illusion and delusion and hallucination always pollute the purity of the mind. To remove these mental impurities and hindrances, we have to work hard and use our confidence and determination. Good result can then be experienced. One must have a lot of patience in order to practice meditation. Most people waste a lot of mental energy not knowing how to harness it. Energy is like a waterfall. Almost every day, the water goes on pouring from the waterfall. An engineer, after studying this, decides to make use of this waterfall and build a dam. Then he can convert the water that he had accumulated into strong energy to produce hydroelectricity to illuminate the whole country. In the same way, we can accumulate the mental energy, harness it, and utilize it for good purpose to serve others and to experience peace and happiness. The Buddha did this during many previous births and developed his mental energy without wasting it unnecessarily. And he finally gained his enlightenment as a result of this mental development. That is why he said that he did not gain his enlightenment through the influence of external forces or divine powers, but by using his own effort. People like to know many things regarding meditation practices. For example, they inquire about food, time, and posture. Regarding our food, actually there is no restriction, but we should not take a heavy meal, especially at night time. If you take a heavy meal before your meditation, you experience many difficulties. That is why the Buddha advised the monks and those who observe 8 precepts not to have solid food at night. Some people think that Buddhists should not take meat but eat only vegetable food. There is no such precept in the teachings of the Buddha. However, those who want to be vegetarians may do so as a personal preference. Although some people prefer vegetarian food, it is not a religious law. Those who go and practice meditation, either in the jungles or cemeteries, especially at night, do avoid certain types of meat for their protection from certain animals and evil spirits. Posture is important to prevent physical problems. Since mind is not used to this discipline, when we try to control our mental energy, the energy can create a lot of disturbances in our body, such as pain, difficulties in blood circulation, headache, backache, giddiness, and some other problems. So, the proper posture helps to prevent the obstruction of the blood circulation, and it supports the organs and the glands to function properly. Those who sit down for many hours experience numbness and ache. Walking meditation is prescribed by the Buddha to prevent this problem. That is why some people prefer walking meditation. If the mind is wandering here and there, it cannot be controlled by the posture we take. Therefore, we should not depend on posture for meditation. The posture used by the Buddha to gain enlightenment is known as lotus posture, and that particular posture strengthens the back to support blood circulation to the brain. For those who experience difficulties in sleeping, is to read a book on a deep subject such as philosophy, psychology, or certain subjects which do not entertain the mind. Then the mind becomes very lazy. The book also drops from the hand and you can go to sleep. Those who pray according to their religion and read some religious books to understand the true nature of existing things indirectly do practice meditation. However, if they pray with selfish motive to gain some worldly material thing, it cannot be regarded as true meditation. In meditation, there must be purity in the mind. Today, all over the world, people talk about air pollution, water pollution, but people never think of mental pollution. Man's mind pollutes the whole world and atmosphere by radiating anger, jealousy, grudge, hatred, and various other evil forces. These evil mental forces can change the normal cosmic energy and disturb the whole universe. Because these energies are the most forceful energies. This meditation is common to everybody, irrespective of their race, religion, or any other differences. Meditation is the great force that can make this world a truly beautiful place to live. The ugliness of the human race is mind created. If the mind of man can be controlled through meditation, this can indeed be a heaven on earth. Just as an engine gets overheated and damaged when it is run for a prolonged period and requires cooling down to overcome the heat, so also the mind gets overtaxed when we subject it to a sustained degree of mental effort, and it is only through meditation that relaxation or cooling down of the mind could be achieved.